Hi everybody, welcome to the 2021 Woodleigh Arts Festival. Yet again, we're presenting our Arts Festival to you remotely as we adapt and we change and we innovate to come to terms with our current lockdown situation. All art requires an audience. Art is prepared, whether it's visual or whether it's performing, to please an audience, to impact on an audience, to challenge an audience, and to make you feel a certain way. So this week I ask you to be the audience, to join us with our various activities and various presentations throughout the week. Check the calendar, check your emails carefully, and join us and be part of the Woodleigh Arts Festival as we innovate, we change, and we create something new in a new environment this year. And hopefully in 2022, we return to normal and we come on site to see our great performers and our students doing the best they can do on site. Have a wonderful week and enjoy the festival.
Thank you. Kia ora all. I've just had word from Tintin that they'll be arriving home from London on Friday.
That is good news, Mr. Tracy. I am a racial stereotype. Good news, Mr. Tracy.
Okay, Coronel. Just keep that to yourself next time. Now, do I have any new messages on the dashboard? Because I was... Come in, John.
U.S. Space Station Skylab is believed they're in imminent danger of crash landing in Australia. International Rescue have received the call, sir. And also, Father, I was just wondering, maybe one day I could come home? I've been in space for a very long time. I haven't felt touch in a very long time. I feel very underutilized here, Father. Father?
All right. Only took me 2 minutes to get into my chair that time. Virgil, preparing for liftoff.
All right, everyone, let's just calm down.
You mind cutting me loose here, pal? Thank you. All right, you Aussies, settle down. International Rescue is ready to respond. I said International Rescue is ready to respond. Come on, Thunderbirds are go. We fly in, save the day. Look, we saved the...
Fire flash coming in. I'm clocking in about 300 here on the dashboard. Does anyone else smell that smoke? Oh, wait. That's me. It's the late 70s. I can smoke wherever I want.
Oh, no. I don't know what we're going to do about this. Maybe this is the perfect opportunity to call in International Rescue. But Thunderbird 1 couldn't do it alone. He needed the help from the best Thunderbird. My Thunderbird. The Thunderbird 2. Oh no! Evil Man the Bomb, he's getting away!
Take the shot, Parker. I think we're in business, boys. And then the credits roll.
Nothing? Okay. Thought that was a good episode. What about when we rescued those guys out of that pit of peril? How on earth are we, the military, gonna get our boys out of this pit of peril that we have created?
Sir, there seems to be only one option. We need to call in International Rescue.
He needed help again. Gee whiz, what I'd give to have those boys on my team. And then the credits rolled. Come on, people loved that rescue. I mean, it wasn't the epic shootout in episode 3. Tell my wife and kids.
That's how I really wanted the shootout to go, but it kind of looked a little bit more like...
Nothing? Jeez, look.
Hear me out. We have a perfect plan to pitch for you today. Picture your average episode of Thunderbirds.
It's me, John Tracy again, with the same glass of scotch as last time.
What's that? U.S. Space Station Skylab, crash landing in Australia. I've got the perfect man for the job. He's brave. He's dangerous. He's devilishly handsome. He's my favorite son. It's Virgil Tracy in the Thunderbird 2!
Yeah, woo, woo!
Approaching Skylab.
Skylab.
Approaching Skylab. Detaching hook. Making contact. Engaging super speed winch technology. Heading home. And then back in time for a shrimp on the babby with you Aussies. You don't say that? Sorry, noted. Look, if you take a look at any rescue in history, I guarantee you the birds could do it better.
Oh, I cannot wait for fine rendition of Chekhov's Seagull, huh? Oh, I did not know Chechen rebels would be involved in this performance, huh? They look like real guns that could cause real harm to a real human person, huh? Real bullets, too. Director must be using Stanislavski's method, huh?
life, we have rescued another.
Hey, look at me, look at me. I am the captain now.
Hello?
I'm here with Captain Phillips, who has just been rescued by the U.S. Navy. Now, Mr. Phillips, how the hell do you think that that rescue relates to yours, Virgil? Now, look, mate, we really appreciate you coming out all this way, but the truth is that we need someone expendable. And, if we were going to use the Thunderbird, we'd go with Five, because he's up in space. But, the real truth is, try calling yourself a hero with no strings attached. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Mrs. Clark, I'm glad to hear you enjoyed our very own American bar last night. Of course, I'll send your thanks to Miguel Robinson. The numbers are not looking good. I cannot imagine what another outbreak would do to. Hello and welcome to the Savoy Hotel London. I'm your concierge, Jane. It's a pleasure to meet your family. Room 84 is free. Well, actually, they're all free at the moment. COVID is crippling tourism. Concierge, yes, that's today. Here is your room key, room 84, and I hope you enjoy your stay at London Savoy Hotel.
Lord Almighty, feel my temperature rising, higher, higher, it's burning through to my soul. Girl, 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 you're gonna set me on fire.
I'm so sorry, I'm late. Came as quickly as I could.
As I was saying, ladies and gentlemen, the new blueprints illustrate the multi-level parking lot that will stand in the place of your hotel and will what make you an absolute fortune. Isn't that right, Mr. Grocon?
Did you hear that, Miguel? They want to turn us into a car park. London is emerging from a pandemic. Of course, tourism is low at present. Don't you remember how successful and prestigious the Savoy has always been? London, August 6, 1889, when London Savoy Hotel first opened its doors, I want no expense spared. The courtyard will be flooded to conjure the Grand Canal of Venice. Baby elephants will pull lavish cakes that will tower more than 100 centimeters high. The Savoy will be the place to see and be seen, to wine and dine and be entertained. You see, the Savoy Hotel is a national treasure. History has been made here. If the walls could talk, if the roof could talk, Freddy, brother, dear, I hear the views of London from above are positively fantastic. What do you say, Freddy, darling? Dance!
I won't dance, don't ask me. I won't dance, don't ask me. I won't dance, matter with you. My heart won't let my feet do things that they should do.
Quiet, Alfred, I'm writing. I'll be back to bed shortly. Lying on the floor was a dead man in evening dress with a knife in his heart. It was not until they examined the rings that they recognized who it was. I have nothing to declare except my excellence. Elfie, it is so kind of Richard Doyley Cart, family friend and owner of this fine hotel, to allow us to stay here together. And while I must say, it accommodates my every pleasure, as do you, Alfred. Does this scarf suit me, darling? George, we require some extra satin sheets. We both know the staff here are renowned for keeping stum. Clive, be a good chap and fetch us a bottle of brandy. Oh, and remind the concierge to send that young fellow Troy up to stoke the fire. Hello, Troy.
Troy, did you hear the chambermaid got called in as a witness?
All rise! Oscar Wilde, you are hereby convicted and sentenced to 2 years hard labor for gross indecency.
Gross indecency, indeed. It was the end of my career, my marriage, and my place in society. But I will not stand ashamed of who I am. The Savoy gave me my freedom. And to this day, they still welcome everybody. Ha!
These days, everybody welcomes everybody. Your celebrities are too nostalgic. Plenty of other London hotels have a history. And your people, your staff, we've arranged them to become car park attendants. Our staff, our family. I was a chambermaid before they welcomed me in. I remember my staff stay like it was yesterday. Oh, it isn't our new concierge pleasure to
to meet you. My name is Tony. Oh, no, no need to worry. It's the business. I swear I could carry the gun. No, I literally do. Ha! Anyway, I will surely arrive safely to your room. Enjoy your complimentary staff stay.
Hiya, I met a kid. Heard you were staying the night. Oh, well, I picked these just for you this morning. New concierge is very, very exciting. These are for you. Enjoy your stay.
G'day, my name is Gary, and I will be your personalized butler during your stay. Now, whatever you need or require, I will ensure it is acquired to you as soon as possible in the jiffiest jiffy. Now, between you and me, I sensed you wanted some champers. Welcome to the family. The Savoy Hotel has set a standard for hotels across the world, even inspiring the film and television industry. Have you seen the Grand Budapest Hotel, for example?
A tale of a handsome and legendary concierge.
And an elderly female guest.
Who held a mutual love for one another until she was found
dead.
Framed for murder on a mission to recover a priceless Renaissance painting. The concierge and lobby boy go beyond the desk and take a journey to solve this guest's murder mystery.
Like Monsieur Gustave, we will do anything for our guests. And that includes ensuring this hotel does not become a car park. We will unite and we will win. Robertson, keep the bookings coming. Oh, and get Boris on the phone. He'll be appalled with this buffoonery.
le temps de l'amour, le temps des copains et de l'aventure. Quand le temps va et vient, on ne pense à rien malgré ses blessures. Car le temps de l'amour, c'est long et c'est court, ça dure toujours, on s'en souvient.
See your own movie. Okay, let's get ready, guys. Come on. Come on. Oh, I've worked so hard on this. Let's roll.
In a world, a group of boys shipwrecked on an island, left with nothing to survive except the clothes on their backs. And the clothes on their fronts. They must work together to survive and thrive and defeat the monster on Skull Island!
Everybody, one for your lives! It's a non-copyright version of King Kong!
Oh, he's not that scary after all.
Oh, never mind! Take this, Mr. Kong! Peel, 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 peel! Give us everything you got! Oh, he broke my white leg! Oh, take this! And an RPG for some reason! Oh, there's no hope! What are we supposed to do? Wait, is that Arnold Schwarzenegger?
This is me, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
No, Arnold! It's a pleasure to meet you! What are you doing in a helicopter?
Nice to meet you. What's going on?
Well, this massive monkey's trying to kill us boys! And he broke Tony's leg!
Yeah, it really hurts. Save us, Arnie.
Okay!
Yeah. I'm not sure what seems to be the problem. Yeah. They seem to not like enjoy the movie or like the class thing either. Okay. Let's wrap this up, boys. Let's wrap this up. What seems to be the problem? Oh, okay, I see. Not enough Arnold. Oh, too much Arnold. Okay. Oh, you think it's too dramatic. Okay, listen, boys, you think you know dramatic? I'll show you dramatic. Do you boys remember the story of I'm the King of the World? Well, this boat with 2,246 people on it sure is cool. I hope it doesn't like hit an iceberg or anything.
Wherever you are.
Oh, Rose, aren't we lucky we found this floating door in the middle of the North Atlantic? It looks like in excess of 1,500 people might die tonight. Oh, after an iceberg has hit a Titanic, what a tragedy. Oh, I'll never let go, Jack. Okay, thanks, Rose.
Rose, surely there's enough room on this door for me, Rose. Okay, Rose, I'm actually slipping. Rose, I'm drowning, no. Rose, I'm still slowly drowning. Why is it taking so long?
Boring, dumb, stupid story. Until James Cameron came along and dramatized it with a little bit of death. Romance. And gratuitous nudity. Ha! Instant blockbuster. Whoa, boys. Calm down, listen. All six of you, calm down. Listen, I know you think I'm trying to embellish your true story of how you got washed up in an island for 9 months. Oh, I'm sorry. 15 months. But listen, boys. This is Hollywood. And the thing about Hollywood is, honestly, your story is kind of boring, and we don't care.
This is way better than the school lunches, boys.
Hey.
It looks like it's starting to rain, boys.
Maybe we should head back to shore.
What do you mean we should head back to shore?
Oh no, it could be dangerous or something.
Oh, you scared of a little rain, huh?
Someone help us! We've lost the sail!
Hey, boys. I think we're lost.
Oi, boys! I got one! Looks like we're having fish and chips tonight! Except without the chips, of course. Hey, cheer up, boys!
He can't be that dead.
If we don't find exploding coconuts, how do we collect the rainwater to drink? Looks like it's yours, Siptaika. Hey, boys! Boys, wake up! We've got land! Everybody off the ship! One, two, three, four, five, six! Let's swim! Hey, boys! Under here for tonight. Oh, boys, I'm so hungry I could eat a bird. I'm so hungry I could eat that bird. Hold back, boys. I think I found ourselves some lunch. Ah! Hey, boys! Up here! I think I found a way up to the mainland! Oh, look at me! Everyone, come on! I'm the king of the world! I don't even know where that's from! Hey, you! Start a fire! You, collect some fruit! Looks like we're gonna be here for a while. Everyone, gather round. Let's make a pact. Everyone, repeat after me. I swear to never fight or argue, even when I'm really, really ticked off. And that is the most important rule of them all. For 9 months, 15 months, we lived on the island. We lived in harmony. We did not fight. We did not argue. We did not fight. Who is Mr. Kong? I do not know Kong. Please, fix your story. Tell our story.
Yeah.
It's Octavian. He's declared war on me. Oh, sorry, beloved Isis. I bring you an offering of flowers, milk, incense, and honey. Now I'm going to have to lead a fleet of Egyptian warships or something. Ugh! According to Octavian, I am cunning, seductive, and perform acts of witchery! He's just scared because he knows that I'm more powerful than him. You know, you and I are alike in that way, Isis. We're both powerful. And this world needs powerful women. Harlequin, nice to meet you. I love your perfume. What is that? The stench of death? Anyways, me and Puddin broke up for real this time. I am going to kill you for everything you've done to me. For all the times you've made me feel useless and small. For all the times you've hurt me for the last time. See you later, Puddin. I'm so excited. Rome, oh Rome, it's your riches I desire. The abundant crops, the plentiful mines, and of course, the goods. But Caesar, how do I get to you without my brother seeing me? Oh, a linen stack. Caesar, fancy seeing you here. Egypt is in dire need of your help. Why would you help my brother when you could help me? Caesar, Caesar! Caesar? Dead? Stabbed 23 times. Caesar, my protector. Assassinated. Ah, Isis, the protector of women. Many of the young girls in my kingdom see me in much the same light. It would be such a shame if those poor, beautiful young girls didn't have somebody to look up to anymore. Now, now, my people, hear my words. Egypt will be the wealthiest, most protected, most intelligent kingdom there is. Our military will be expanded, and we shall not be overthrown. Trust me, together we shall make Egypt great again. Our thoughts on Cleopatra, she's truly reassuring. She makes our kingdom safe, our kingdom she's restoring. Over 80,000 infantry and 4,000 cavalry, she's powerful and strong. Our pharaoh's never wrong. She's boosted our economy and strengthened our military. Pharaoh Cleopatra will always be legendary. Isis, if I lose this battle, I shall die. What shall become of me? Oh, what shall become of my beloved? Antony, oh, my beloved Antony. Oh, Antony, it's me, Cleopatra. Pharaoh of Egypt, dressed in the robes of Isis. The goddess, not the terrorist organization. Rome could use my riches right now, and I could use protection. But there's power to be had. More power! More power! Oh, Antony, my darling, how could you resist? Look at her on that massive sailboat. Mate, Cleopatra wants me. Yeah, Rome could use her riches right now. She is beautiful. Kinda sexy even. Better than the bloody missus inside, am I right?
All right, shut up, woman. I'm coming. Oh, Isis, it's a story as old as time. You can relate, right? You were so in love with your husband Osiris. All of the pain and the terror you would have felt with his passing. Antony mustn't endure the same pain should I slip away. Antony, if it is love indeed, tell me how much.
There is beggary in love that can be reckoned.
Isis, I'm a good lover. Everybody says so. Oh, like you, I am cunning. Leading men into difficult, dangerous, or disastrous situations. Sounds like me! I'm cooperating, all right? This is me being cool.
Huh? We're bad guys. It's what we do. Drink this, dear brother.
Drink it. Drink it all. I had to marry you, dear brother. But now that you are dead, I'll have to take the lead. We are bad guys, Isis. It's what we do. Help me to defeat Octavian and help me to continue my reign!
You called me a useless, selfish prick. So I'm in a fix right now, and we'll measure the truth somehow. Love is a funny thing to me. Then you stormed out and grabbed your coat while slamming shut the door. A ruthless move, so cold you left your keys inside the door. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ooh. Can nothing I do make you happy anymore? Nothing I say put a smile onto your face. Can nothing I say bring us back together? Nothing I do put a smile onto your face. Day I called you back, and you called me a stupid twat. And then you were crying on the phone. You sounded so upset. You said I wasn't the man you met 3 years and 7 months ago. I pleaded with her, take me back, I'll change my sorry ways. So tell me why, mysteriously, I'm annoyed instead of shamed. Ooh. Can nothing I do make you happy anymore? Nothing I say put a smile onto your face. Can nothing I say bring us back together? Nothing I do put a smile onto your face. Pondering it all after that call, I think it is clear. If I am here, you're from another stratosphere. Now all the things she said, they run around my head and come out my ear. And not before long, so-and-so thinks he's done no wrong. And as grander questions flutter round my head like butterflies, my head spins out reflecting on another love's demise. Ha ha. Can nothing I do make you happy anymore? Nothing I say put a smile onto your face. Can nothing I do bring us back together? Nothing I say put a smile onto your face. Well, come on, all together now.